beautiful kit, beautiful drum set.
Clarence Acox knows something about these drums.
I remember this set very, very well. It looks good and I know it sounds good.
A respected drummer and teacher, Clarence Acox is at once a staple of the Northwest jazz scene, gigging with his own band, co-founding the Seattle Repertory Jazz Orchestra, and the music teacher who has piloted the Garfield High School Jazz Ensemble to national acclaim. If he has inspired legions of young musicians, he is also himself inspired by his own jazz heroes, notably the late Elvin Jones, whom he went to see at Seattle's Jazz Alley every chance he got.
Oh yeah, that was a must. Me being a drummer, and I don't go see Elvin Jones, that would be crazy.
This is Jazz Alley, where Clarence Acox came to hear Elvin Jones play dozens of times. And this is First and Cherry in downtown Seattle, where in a jazz club that once stood here, Elvin Jones played on an album recorded in 1965, the legendary John Coltrane's Live in Seattle. Elvin Jones was a drummer other jazz giants would go out of their way to work with. Giants like Coltrane. Why was Elvin Jones such an icon?
He approached it from a spiritual aspect of it, so he was serious about what he was doing. So he always brought a lot of energy and enthusiasm to the stage, and that was transcended to the audience.
And Elvin Jones' spirit is in this room.
The drums have a very good sound. Not only are they beautiful, but they sound good. And I felt like I was channeling a spirit from somewhere else.
You see, this drum set was Elvin's own, one of his last. The brass badges attest to that. The bass drum head proudly proclaims you are in the presence of the Elvin Jones Jazz Machine. And it's here at Don Bennett's drum studio in Bellevue.
I just feel really fortunate to have this drum in my hands.
Dealing in vintage drums is simply what Don Bennett does. After Elvin Jones died in 2005, his widow, Keiko, called from New York to ask Bennett for help.
She had, 35 years worth of Elvin's drums, an entire apartment full of Elvin's drums.
It took 3 years to find the right homes for most of the drums. But among the instruments that made it here to Seattle was this big gold sparkle Yamaha drum kit. And it seems only natural that Clarence Acox should break its silence.
You know, playing drums is just like playing music. You want dynamic range, you want volume range, you want different colors, you want different sounds, you want different textures. And what happens is when you have these other drums as an option, it helps you in putting together some ideas that you think you might want to lay on the public.
To play a vintage instrument is to feel all the hands that have touched it. To play an instrument once owned by a legend is to feel that legend flowing through you. And as long as these drums hold together,
Elvin Jones is in the house.